questions for tomorrow. There have been times I didn't know right from wrong. But in every situation, God gave less consolation. That my trials came to only make me strong.
Through it all,
oh yes,
through it all, I've learned to trust in Jesus. I've learned to trust in God.
For the mountains and I thank him for the valleys, and I thank him for the storms he's brought me through.
He's brought me through.
For if I'd never had a problem,
yeah,
I'd never know that God could solve that.
I would never know, yeah.
I'd never know what faith in his word could do. And now I can say,
just lift your voice and lift your hand and give him praise. Give him praise in your house. Hallelujah. Let's all stand to our feet and just worship him this morning. Give him praise. I just wanted to love him despite what you might be passing through now. Just love him. Just love him. Regardless of what you might be going through now, just love him. Just love him. Just go ahead and love him. Thank you, Jesus. Father, thank you. Father, thank you. Father, we give you praise. Go ahead and say, Father, I love you. I give you praise. I give you honor. I give you adoration alone. Thank you, Jesus. My Jesus, I love thee, I know thou art mine. For thee all the follies of sin I resign. My gracious Redeemer, my Savior, thou art. Even thy Lord of thee, my Jesus, this night. My Jesus, I love thee. I know thou art mine. For thee, O thou holiest of sin, I resign. My gracious Redeemer, my Savior, art thou, even by law of thee, my Jesus, this now I love you, Lord, and I lift my voice. Just say you love him. To worship you. Let somebody love God this morning.
My soul.
Let somebody just love God.
Rejoice.
Take joy,
my King, in what you give. Let it be a sweet sound in your.
Come on, somebody just love him this morning. Hallelujah. I love you, Lord.
I love you, Lord. And I lift my voice to worship. Oh, my soul.
I so rejoice. Hallelujah.
Rejoice.
Take joy, Mama.
Take joy, my King. In what you hear, may it be a sweet. Sweet sound in your ear.
Let somebody just love him. Say something that will be a sweet sound in his ear. Say something that will be a sweet sound. Say something that will be a sweet sound.
Maybe I'll sweet. Sweet sound in your ear.
Just love him, hallelujah. Just love him. Just love him. Just love him. I love you, Lord. I love you. I love you. I love you. Just put all the problems, all the troubles aside and just love him. Just love him. Just love him. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you.
In your ear.
Thank you, Jesus. We love you, Lord. We love you. We love you, Lord. We love you, Jesus. Jesus, we love you. 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 In Jesus' mighty name, we worship. Amen. Praise the name of Jesus. Praise the name of the Lord. I'd like you to turn to somebody that is seated close to you and ask him or her, do you still love Jesus? Despite what you're going through, do you still love Jesus? Praise the name of Jesus. Praise the name of the Lord. Somebody says, when you see somebody that is standing out in a crowd, is sitting on somebody's shoulder. Praise the name of Jesus. I'd like you to please join me and put your hands together for this man of God upon whose shoulder I stand this afternoon, this morning. In the name of Jesus, please put your hands together. Hallelujah. Praise the name of Jesus. Somebody says you need to have a father to have feathers, because without feathers, you cannot fly. Some of us are beginning to fly now because we have a father in the house. Put your hands together again, people of God, for our father in the house. As he's beginning to fly with Jesus, we started to fly with him. Praise Jesus, because we have a father. Praise the name of the Lord. Praise the name of Jesus. In 1991, somebody gave me one tie. Unfortunate thing was that it was the only one that I had. I never had a tie prior to that time. And so I did not know how to knot a tie. Each time I needed to knot it, I would take it to church to somebody to knot for me. And each time I washed it knotted. Praise Jesus. Because if I unravel it by default, it means that I will have to wait until I get to church before I get someone who could knot it for me. But one day, I made up my mind to create a problem for myself to solve. So deliberately, I unraveled it, actually loosed it. And I told myself, you must know how to knot this tie today. Praise the name of Jesus. You must know how to knot a tie today. So I created a problem for myself. People of God, I cannot tell you how many times I tried and failed. Praise the name of Jesus. But you see, you are not a failure until you have given up. Amen. Thomas Edison tried 999 times to get electricity bulb, and he failed until he got to the 1,000th time. And he said to himself, I didn't fail. I only discovered 999 times not to do it. Praise Jesus. So I started to struggle. And finally, I made it. I knotted it. Praise Jesus. I knotted the tie. And I congratulated myself. But then before I did that, before I congratulated myself finally, I needed to convince myself that I now know how to knot the tie. So I unraveled it again. And then I tried to do it again. I didn't get it. And then I tried again. I now got it. So I unraveled it again. And then I got it. I unraveled it again and I got it. Now I said to myself, now I know how to knot this tie. You see, the benefit out of that problem that I created for myself is now, even my supervisor in the office brings his tie to me to knot. Colleagues in the office come to my office. Sometimes I say, I'm going to begin to charge a fee now for knotting ties in the office. Praise Jesus. Hallelujah. I share another one with you. You know, many years ago, about 20 years ago, we had software like WordStar. How many of us use WordStar? WordStar, you use WordStar, you use Word Perfect. Praise Jesus. There was another very cumbersome software called Ventura. How many of us use Ventura? Oh, praise God. Yeah, okay, only these computer scientists who are, praise the Lord. But you see, I had a problem. I was versatile in the use of Ventura. Each place I worked, I used Ventura. But then there was PageMaker. I didn't know how to use PageMaker. So again, I made up my mind, I will create a problem for myself to solve. Amen. So there was a particular year that Nigerian Society of Engineers hired me to work in their office, work in their publication department. And I got in there, the first time I got to my computer, the computer they asked me to use. And when I put on the computer, I realized that the computer had Ventura and it also had PageMaker. So I said to myself, the best thing for you to do if you really want to know how to use this PageMaker is to do away without Ventura. So I decided to take a risk. The first thing that I did when I put on the computer, I removed Ventura. One, I did not tell the head of the office I was going to do that. It was not installed with my money. The other thing is that if I tried to use PageMaker and I couldn't use it, there was no alternative. It is that alternative that I didn't want in place, so I took it off. Praise the name of Jesus. You know, what I found out is that PageMaker is actually more user-friendly. Praise the name of Jesus. Praise the name of the Lord. You know, Robert Shula said something. He said, the impossible problem is solved when we see that the problem is only a tough decision waiting to be made. I bring to us this morning, people of God, problem benefits. Problem benefits. Hallelujah. Problem benefits. Now, what are problems? Problems are difficulties, or troubles, they are crisis, they are dilemma, they are predicaments, they are setbacks. And what are benefits? Benefits means profit, it means advantage, it means help, it means assistance, and it means gain. Praise the name of Jesus. If I asked us this morning, how many of us know how to drive? Raise your hand. You know how to drive? Raise your hand. Just raise your hand. You know how to drive. You may not have a vehicle now, but you know how to drive. You can move a vehicle. Okay. Praise the Lord. Now, how many of us can drive a car with manual gear? You can drive. Okay. Praise the Lord. You can drive, but it is only automatic. You can drive. Raise your hand. You don't know how to drive. You only know how to steer. Praise Jesus. You only know how to. You know, there's a difference between actually driving a car and steering it. Those of you who drive automatic, you're only steering a car. It is the car that is driving itself. Amen. Now, you're running away from problem. That is why you went to learn auto. But there are benefits. I had a story of a woman who was not very nice to her driver. So the driver was waiting for a day to go for her jugular. So one day, as they were driving through somewhere in Ikeja, the driver stopped the vehicle and told Madame, I've had enough of this nagging. I'm no longer going to walk. Why didn't you do it at home? No, this is, I want to resign here. You know, so the woman now, he said, okay, please, let's. He said, no, I'm resigning here. She thought it was a joke. The young man dropped the key, crossed to the other side of the road, and walked off. And so the madam that does not know how to drive became stuck. Out of that problem came the benefit of knowing how to drive. She had to send herself to a driving school. Praise the Lord. I see benefits evolving from somebody's problems beginning from today. In Jesus' mighty name. Let's read the word of God together. The Bible in James chapter 2. James chapter 1. We're going to be reading from verse 2. And I'll be reading quickly from here. My brethren, count it all joy when ye fall into diverse temptations, knowing this, that trying of your faith worketh patience, but let patience have her perfect work, that ye may be perfect and entire, wanting nothing. 2 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 8, we are troubled on every side, yet not distressed. We are perplexed, but not in despair. You have to follow me quickly. Job 23, verse 10. But he knoweth the way that I take. When he hath tried me, I shall come forth as gold. Romans 5:3-5. And not so. But we glory in tribulations also, knowing that tribulation worketh patience, and patience experience, and experience hope. And hope maketh not ashamed, because the love of God is shed abroad in our hearts by the Holy Ghost, which is given unto us. Praise the name of Jesus. You know, this month is already deemed a month of Jehovah. And I realized from the study of the Word of God that this word Jehovah came as benefits from problems that the people of God encountered in the Bible. That was when you hear Jehovah this, Jehovah that. When there's a seeming problem that the people of God are finding difficult to deal with, then God shows up as Jehovah this. I don't know what you are going through, but God is going to show forth as Jehovah in your case. I said, I see God showing forth as Jehovah in your case. I see Jehovah showing forth to fight for you. In the mighty name of Jesus. Now, I want us to go through certain characters in the Bible who obtained benefit from their problems. You know, God became Jehovah. You know, until you get to a point where you became tired of the situation, you may not record Jehovah's intervention. Praise Jesus. We look at the story of Hannah in First Samuel chapter 1. The Bible says there was somebody, in the first place, we are told that she was the first wife. Elkanah was number two. Peninnah, sorry. Elkanah was the husband. And now, you know, whatever you are going through now, people of God, is meant to drive you to your knees. And it is only when you are driven to your knees that your detractors can be confounded. Praise the name of Jesus. The unfortunate thing is that we have a negative attitude to our problems, what we call problems. And by the way, you know, I searched through King James Version. I didn't see where the word problem is reflected in King James. In the contemporary versions, maybe. But in King James, which is what is widely accepted in the church, I couldn't find one word, problem. Which means, in reality, there is no problem anywhere. It is our attitude to what we are going through that makes it appear as if there is a problem. You know, somebody says, you and I, we are just like tea bags. Your worth is not known until you are thrown into hot water. You understand that? You know, when you see a piece of tea now, until it is dropped into hot water, you will not know what it carries. There's something that you carry until you are thrown into a challenge. It will not be released. That's number one. There is none holy as the Lord. Let somebody sing with me now.
There is none beside thee, neither is there anyone like our God. There is none holy as the Lord.
You know, the obstacles of life will not leave you the same way it met you. It will either leave you better or bitter. This song that we just took now came from a seeming problem. Hannah composed it. Praise the name of Jesus. So I see a song being composed out of what you are going through now. Did you hear what I said? I said, I see a song being composed out of what you are passing through now. In the name of Jesus. You know this song? You are far. Sing it with me now.
An Omega. We worship you, our God.
Hallelujah. Amen. You know this song? Do you know that a prisoner composed this song? A prisoner composed this song Now, chances are that he would not have composed any song in his life if he had not been imprisoned. You understand me? So get ready. Something is coming out of what you are going through now. Can I hear a louder amen from somebody? I said, something good is coming out of what you are going through now. In the name of Jesus. Number two. You know the story of Gideon. You know what you are going through now may be designed to reveal the hidden potential that you carry. Praise the name of Jesus. Do you know one thing, people of God? You are more than this. You are more than this. I want you to say to yourself, I'm more than this. Now, in Judges chapter 6, we all know this story. The Bible says the angel came and said to him, the Lord is with you, thou man of valor. And he said, angel, what did you say? I said, you are a man of valor. He said, what did you say? What? He said, valor. There are many men and women of valor that are looking at me now who don't know. The only thing that will bring it out, that potential in you, is a problem. And then, as if that was not enough, he said, go in this might. Go in this might. He said, might. Might. Go in this might. So I want to say to somebody, you need to get out of that problem and go in that might. You know, the problem is that you don't know that you are carrying might. That's what you carry that is called might. And to prove to you, at the end of the day, this man led 300 soldiers to conquer another nation. You see, it takes military prowess for somebody to lead 3 soldiers. They give you 3 soldiers. How many generals are in the house? They give you 3 soldiers and say, go to Borno State. Borno State. 300 soldiers. I'm sorry, the soldiers will say, this one is a suicide mission. I'm not going. Praise the name of Jesus. And then they said, I came from a poor background and my family is the smallest in Judah. Listen to me, it is not all about your family. It is about your God. It is about your God. It is about Jehovah. And I see Jehovah going ahead of you in the name of Jesus. You know, it's going to be unfortunate for you to belong to this church and you allow your pedigree to determine your degree of success in life. Hallelujah. So the problem that you are going through now, you call a problem, is actually meant or might be meant to reveal the real you to you and to your world. Praise the Lord. Number three. The purpose of some problems is to take a man from zero to hero. Where people who had looked down on you can begin looking up to you. You know the story of Jephthah in Judges chapter 11? The Bible says, you know, there are times that you are blamed for a sin that you never committed. You will not be the first one. The Bible says that his kinsmen cast him out because his mother was a harlot or an harlot. They cast him out. My dear brother, you are going somewhere. It is not your parents or your mother that will determine where you are going. But I love this man. The Bible says he left home. He took it in good faith. He left home. And he gathered vain people around him. There was every probability that he didn't go to school. So how about yourself that you have master's degree? And you are allowing your background to keep your back to the ground. Damn it, in the name of Jesus. Now, he went and gathered agberos around himself. Listen, it is not the people that you are gathered around that matters, but your vision, where you are going. But it got to a point when they saw his success, they came to invite him. I went to a car wash one day and I saw one motorcycle. I was wondering, who is the owner of this motorcycle? You know those Suzuki that they used those days? I was making an inquiry, who is the owner of this Suzuki? And one of the guys washing cars there told me it belongs to me. I said, where did you get it from? He said, I brought it from my village. Where's your village? He mentioned one Yoruba community like that. All the way from that place, you rode it to Abuja? He said, yes. What happened? I was interested in his story. He told me, I'm the firstborn in the family, but nobody reckons with me. My younger ones are doing well. But I'm just like a riffraff. So one day he made up his mind and he stole his father's bike and rode it to Abuja. He said, until I make it, I will not go back. I don't know whether he has made it now. I've not seen him since then. Praise the name of Jesus. Now, this is an example of a Jephthah, as it were. Praise the name of the Lord. So there could be a Jephthah now. Maybe they have cast you out. You know, casting you out means that no matter what they are doing in the family, you are not called. Because you don't have what it takes to be called. You need money. Praise the name of Jesus. You need money to be called. You need money to be invited. You know, somebody wants to wed. This is how much. My younger brother was telling me that I think the wife lost her mother recently. And what they allocated to them is $500,000. Your own contribution is $500,000. I almost said, why don't you give me half of the $500,000? So I will pray for you. Somebody who died about 3 months ago, they just buried a $500,000. Now, it is because they have what it takes. So I prophesy in the name of Jesus to every Jephthah in the house. You are moving from zero to hero. I said you are moving from zero to hero in the name of Jesus. Listen to me. When something is going on in your home and maybe they are celebrating something, you don't even need to go there. You don't need to go. All you need is money. Just send money and say, I cannot come. I'm busy getting more money that I can send to you in future. Just take. Once you send money, even if you don't come, you are pardoned. Oh my God. Every Jephthah in the house, you are relocating. You are relocating in the name of Jesus. Let me digress a little bit. I found something in that story in verse 29 of chapter 11. The Bible says, the Spirit of the Lord came over his life, which means God was already with him. And out of ecstasy, he went ahead to make a covenant with God and just killed his daughter for vain. Because at that point, he did not need a covenant, because the Spirit of the Lord was already on him. That's how some of us do. You know, sometimes we make pledges out of ecstasy, out of excitement, without really checking what the Holy Spirit is leading you into. Oh, somebody gave a car. I will also give my car. You may track for a long time. Oh. I'm telling you. Praise the name of Jesus. So what you are going through now could just be God orchestrating something to make those who have been looking down on you to begin to look up to you. In the name of Jesus. Praise the Lord. Number four, some problems are orchestrated to take you to the place of the fulfillment of your dream through the interpretation of others, so that your critics can be proved wrong. You know the story of Joseph? Because of our time, I'm not taking us through the passages. The Bible says, you know, there was a time they were mocking him. Whenever they see him coming, they say, see him, the multicolored man, you know, the man with multiple colored dress is coming again. They were mocking him. And then they threw him into the pit. Let's see how his dream will come to pass. Oh my God. Let us see how his dream will come to pass. He said, listen to me. You may be in the pit now, but I prophesy to you that the palace is ahead of you. You didn't hear what I said? I said, your case may be like somebody who is in the pit now, thrown there by the enemy, but the palace is ahead of you. I said, the palace is ahead of you. So stop complaining. Just endure it. Endure it for a little while. You are going to come out of it soon in Jesus' name. I said, I see you coming out of it in the name of Jesus. I see you coming out of it in the name of Jesus. You know, what you need is the intervention of Jehovah in your case. Amen. And Jehovah will intervene for you in the name of Jesus. And I want to advise us, people of God. You know, there are certain shortcuts that have the potential of cutting your destiny short. If somebody told you, you need a job, you need a job. Just come and meet me in Hilton. You get a job. You may go to Hilton, quite all right, and get a job. But you may have missed your palace ahead of time. You remember? The woman, the wife of the master, said, just come and sleep with me. If he had agreed to sleep with that woman, he would still have been a blessed man. But he would not have been as blessed as he became at the end of the day. And you know what? The master would not have known. It is the woman herself that would have perfected the art of concealing it from the master. But he would not have become the prime minister. You are on your way to somewhere. You didn't hear what I said. I said you are going somewhere. I said you are going somewhere. In the name of Jesus. And every demon planning and gathering together to prevent you from reaching your goal, they are destroyed in the name of Jesus. I speak against them in the name of Jesus. I speak against them in the name of Jesus. One thing about this young man was he never complained. You know, when you are going through challenges and you are complaining, you are elongating the process. You are complaining, you're just complaining. Endure it, endure hardship as a soldier of the Lord. Amen. He endured it until he found himself in the palace. Praise the Lord. I'm running because of our time. Number five, the benefit of certain problems is to take someone from obscurity to celebrity, where their name can be recorded in the hall of fame in life. Amen. From obscurity to celebrity. From obscurity. I bring to you the story of Ruth. I don't know. You know, God is wonderful. When I looked at the story, when you look at all the characters mentioned in the book of Ruth, Ruth was not supposed to be the one that the book of Ruth should have been named after. Amen. Because it was just a daughter-in-law. How many of us here, with your business empire, you have a business empire, and at the end of the day, you just look, okay, my son is no longer there, this other one is no longer there, but your wife is still alive, and you decided, it is my daughter-in-law that will take over the business. And this is what has happened. Now, what problem is greater than the loss of a spouse? I think they conducted a research in America and they found out that the most devastating thing in America is the loss of a spouse, followed by separation, divorce. So it's a big problem for somebody to lose a spouse. But listen to me, the loss of a spouse does not mean the end for you. You're not going to lose your spouse in Jesus' name. But you see, there are certain things that can compare to a spouse. You know what you love so much, what you cherish so much, and what you could hardly do without. But because of that, you know, if her husband had not died, I tell you, we would not have had the book of Ruth. Maybe the book of Ruth, I mean, the Bible would have been 66 books, but we would not have had the book of Ruth. I pray in the name of Jesus. Somebody looking at me now, you may be in a state of obscurity, but you are going to move to a place of celebrity. I don't know whether you can hear me. I said you are moving from obscurity to celebrity. If you believe it, shout a loud hallelujah. Number six. You see, what you are going through now, somebody's salvation may be connected to it. What you are going through now. You know, the Bible says in the book of Acts chapter 16 about Paul and Silas. They were locked up in the prison. Listen to me. And the Bible says they began to sing. Keep singing in the prison in which you find yourself now. Something is going to happen. An earthquake that will turn around your situation is coming soon. I thought somebody would say amen. And the Bible says in the night, there was an earthquake. And the door of the prison was open. Somebody's prison door will open after today. Yeah. I said, somebody's prison door is going to open after today. Yeah. But the issue is, the Bible says, the warden in the prison came up and was afraid and was about to kill himself. And they shouted, "Don't kill yourself, we are still alive here." Cut a long story short, people of God, you understand it. The man asked, "How do I give my life to Jesus? I want to give my life to Jesus. I've seen miracles." You see, when people see the miracles of God in your life, it will not take time for you to preach to them. Amen. So that kind of miracle that will locate you, that will cause people to come and give their life to Jesus, may it locate you in the name of Jesus. I said, may it locate you in the name of Jesus. But that's not the issue. You know, they left the prison and nobody knew about it. This jailer took them to his house, treated them well, got every member of his family led to Christ. And as if, and I believe, that that was exactly the case. The following day, the magistrate sent a message, "Go and release these people." The reason for which they were locked up in the prison had been performed. You understand? The benefit of they have been locked up in the prison is for these people to be led to Jesus. So you see, there are some people who are looking at what you are going through now. They will eventually give their life to Jesus. And so they were released. So you see, when you have touched the lives that you are supposed to touch in that seemingly difficult situation, that prison-like situation, when you have touched the people that you are supposed to touch, there will be a release. Did you hear what I said? There will be a release. What you need to do is carry out a check. Am I touching the lives that I'm supposed to touch? Could that be the reason I'm still in this prison? I see a release in the name of Jesus. I said, I see a release in the name of Jesus. Finally, certain problems are designed to turn your pains into gains. You know, there are gainful pains. It is only when you endure the pains that the gains will come out. When you endure the pains, the gains will come out. When you endure the pains, the gains will come out. And you know what is happening in our contemporary world? There are those who will not see the time that you are driving a car that is smoking. And you have to go and top up. Like that 505 that man of God had. Amen. But when you start driving an ML, that is when people will see you. When you start driving a new Camry, people see you. Those who did not see your 505 that was smoking, that you are having to, and praise the name of Jesus. I pray in the name of Jesus, all those eyes that are seeing the good now, who didn't see the things that you went through, and because they hate you, because of that they hate you, those eyes will receive Holy Ghost fire. And you hear what I said? I said, those eyes will receive Holy Ghost fire. There are certain problems that contain gains. There are certain pains that contain gains. It is only when you endure it. Listen to the word of God. I use Jesus as an example here. Hallelujah. Mark 15:34. The Bible says, "And at the ninth hour, Jesus cried with a loud voice, saying, Eloi, Eloi, lama sabachthani, which is being interpreted, my God, why hast thou forsaken me?" Praise the Lord. My God, why hast thou forsaken me? Maybe you are crying out, my God, why have you forsaken me in this situation? My God, why have you forsaken me in this particular case? I see gains coming out of that situation in Jesus' name. I said, I see gains coming out of it in the name of Jesus. Now think about it. Everybody looking at me now, whose sin have been forgiven, you are gained from that pain that Jesus Christ went through. You know what it means? Jesus Christ told Father, and his Father looked away because of you and I. And just think about the number of churches in Abuja alone today. Those are gains from the pains that Jesus Christ went through. I see your own pains releasing to you your gains in the name of Jesus. I don't see, if you're in the house this morning, hallelujah, you are supposed to be Jesus' gain. But the sin in your life is preventing. Jesus is saying, come. All I need is for you to come, and I will wash you clean. I'll wash everything clean, and then you become my gain. And I believe there are gains for Jesus in the house this morning. Let's rise to our feet, people of God. Let's rise to our feet. I love you, Lord, and I lift my voice to worship you, oh my soul. Rejoice, take joy, my King. With all eyes closed, people of God. There's none of these cases that we went through quickly that did not have a relationship with God. You know, you want Jehovah to intervene in your affairs, you need to have a relationship with Him. All you need is for your sin to be forgiven, that's all. While all eyes are closed, I invite here to the pulpit. First, just raise your hand. You want your sin forgiven. Just raise your hand. I want my sin forgiven. I just want my sin forgiven. Just raise your hand. So that I can record intervention of Jehovah in my life. Just raise your hand wherever you are. Hallelujah. Just raise your hand. Just come forward. Let's pray for forgiveness of sin. Just come. Just come to the front. Just come. 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 Come, sister. Come. Come, brother. Just come. Just come. I want my sin forgiven so that Jehovah can intervene in the affairs of my life. Just come. Just come. Yes, come. Come. Come, brother. Thank you. God bless you. Come. 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 Just come. Come. Everybody, just come. Come. I want my sin forgiven. Just come. Just come. My brothers and my sisters standing. I just want my sin to be forgiven so that Jehovah can intervene. Just come, yes, come, 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 just come, 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 yes, come. God bless you, God bless you, brother. Just come, just come, yes, come, come, come. The Holy Spirit is bringing some more people now. Just come, come and have an encounter with you. Yes, thank you, brother. Come, come, come. My song every day, Father, draw me nearer, draw me nearer, nearer to Thee. My song every day, my song every day, Father, draw me nearer, oh, draw.
every day. Father, draw me nearer, Lord.
Draw me nearer, nearer to Thee.
Hallelujah. I have a deep conviction on the inside of me that there are other people who are still waiting. Just come. Just come. We just want to pray with you. We just want to pray with you. Just come. Just come. Wherever you are, please come. Come. Today is the day of salvation, for tomorrow may be too late.
Closer to Thee, closer to Thee, Lord, draw me closer, closer to Thee. Closer to Thee, closer to Thee.
About 26 years ago, I did what you just did. And since then, it has been new songs. I'd like you to close your eyes and just say after me, Jesus. Say after me, Lord Jesus, I release my heart to you today. I release my heart to you today. Wash me with your blood and make me new. Wash me with your blood and make me new. Father, thank you for these ones that came to Jesus. Holy Spirit, thank you. Holy Spirit, thank you. Holy Spirit, thank you. Holy Spirit, thank you. Thank you for bringing these ones to know Jesus. I pray in the name of Jesus, as you have upheld me for the past 26 years, uphold these ones. Write their names in the book of life. Write their names in the book of life with the blood of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Please, you see this pastor, please just follow him. Oh, he's going to give you more counsel. My song every day, Father,
draw me nearer.
Offering time. It's offering time. Pastor Robinson, the Lord bless you. Each time I hear all these our pastors minister here, I just realize how blessed we are to have this wonderful man of God around us. It is not until you see people jump and shout further and die before the miracles happen.